Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Perhaps this is your first time joining with us. We extend a welcome to you. We want to begin with prayer this morning. We want to continue to pray for our president and our nation. We want to continue to pray for our local community, and we want to pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. And there are many, many church members that need special prayer. Perhaps you're aware of some of them, and it would be good to mention them by name. Also, perhaps you have a special unspoken request. This is a perfect time to make that known unto God. Let's pray together. Father, we love you, we praise you, we worship you. We thank you, God, that you loadeth us daily with benefits. Father, we pray for our nation and our president. We pray that you keep your hands upon him, navigate his steps, and keep your hand upon our country. Father, we also pray for our local community that you will continue to open up doors of utterance that we can communicate this great truth. And Father, we pray for our brothers and sisters here at Cornerstone. We pray that you'll open up the windows of heaven and pour out your virtue, your strength. And God, we pray that you'll blanket this congregation with your power, your provision, and your protection. We ask all of this in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ, and everybody said, Amen. I'd like to direct your attention to a passage of scripture found in 2 Timothy chapter number 4. Just two verses of scripture here in verse 10 and 11. 2 Timothy 4, 10 and 11. For Demas hath forsaken me, having loved this present world, and is departed unto Thessalonica. Crescens to Galatia, Titus unto Dalmatia. Only Luke is with me. Take Mark and bring him with thee, for he is profitable to me for the ministry. Once again, Demas hath forsaken me, having loved this present world, and is departed unto Thessalonica. Verse 11, only Luke is with me. Take Mark and bring him with thee, for he is profitable to me for the ministry. Starters, quitters, and finishers. Starters, quitters, and finishers. Here in this incredible benediction found in 2 Timothy chapter number 4, we have the Apostle Paul mentioning two men in particular that hold great importance to what we want to talk about here this morning. First of all, he mentions Demas as forsaking him, having loved this present world and departing to go to Thessalonica. Of course, Thessalonica was a place that, much like Athens, was given to idolatry. And Demas, having had enough of the ministry, leaves and abandons the Apostle Paul, having loved this present world. That is a horrible thing to be said about an individual, but the reality of it is that there are a lot of people that start out in the ministry that don't make it. And there's a lot of people that start out on this Christian journey. And I'm not just saying that in a general or a denominational sense. I'm talking about people that obey the truth and pursue the things of God. But somewhere in the journey, they give up. They quit. And I want to tell you something. There's no place for quitters in the kingdom of God. And there will be no quitters in heaven. That's exactly right. Once we begin this journey, we need to understand that God is with us and God has called us out of darkness into this marvelous light. And though there are enemies, or as Paul said, there are many adversaries, God is good, God is great, God is always with us, and God will never forsake us. But heaven is worth it all. It really is. And there's a lot of people that think that, you know, things can be pretty good in this life with all of the conveniences and all of the choices and all of the accoutrements of our modern culture make this world a place that we could call home forever. I want to say, brothers and sisters, this world is not my home. I do appreciate the modern conveniences. I appreciate having water that all you have to do is turn a knob and you have water. I appreciate a hot water heater. I could go on all morning. But this pales in comparison to what heaven has to offer. But Demas started out with good intentions. But probably the persecution, seeing the pressure that was surmounting against the great apostle, knowing that his days were numbered and his days were short. Just that pressure, Demas said, you know, I've had enough. But it wasn't just the pressure. Paul said, having loved this present world. But uniquely, in the very next verse, he addresses Luke and he says, bring Mark, for he is profitable to me for the ministry. And so we have this incredible contrast between Demas that quits, having loved this present world, and Mark that is being requested to come, for he is profitable. If you know anything about Mark, you'll know that in Acts chapter number 13, he quit also. The Bible says that he left and went back to Jerusalem. Perhaps he saw the price tag was going to be a little too great to enter into the pressures of the ministry. Perhaps he recognized that, you know what, I enjoyed the miracles. I enjoyed feeling the power of the Holy Ghost. I enjoyed feeling the inspiration of the moment. But now that the price has to be paid, he left and went back to Jerusalem. In fact, in Acts chapter number 15, you may recall that Barnabas wanted to take John Mark with him, and he was withstood by the Apostle Paul. And the Bible said that the contention was so great that the two of them separated. Barnabas begins to just evaporate from Scripture as the Apostle Paul begins to march forward and becomes a predominant force in the establishing of the Church of the Living God. But somewhere, John Mark got it back together and recognized, you know, I'm not really a quitter. The influence of Barnabas, the influence of the Apostle Peter, he found a place of encouragement, he found a place of restoration, and he said, you know what? I started out and I'm going to finish. An incredible dynamic here, an incredible distinct comparison between Demas, that is never spoken of again, and John Mark, who prays back through, finds a place of purpose, and now is being requested by the great Apostle Paul. Starters, quitters, and finishers. I've made up my mind. I'm going all the way. God bless you. Thank you for joining us here this morning. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.